Transport is a major emissions culprit. Without intervention, transport could make up 40% of all energy emissions by 2030. So we, from the transport sector, we need to be completely focused on decarbonization our sector. Where transport emissions are heading? If you see this graphic and we don't do anything, we will reach more than 12, around 14 gigatons emissions in our sector, in the land transport emissions. But we can act and we can reduce it. We can work to reduce it around 2 gigatons on 2050. Transport upheaval. I want to share with you the good, the bad, and the ugly in our area after this pandemic. The good: clear skies and less congestion. Mount Everest is visible from Kathmandu for the first time in decades. We reduced the transport emissions, may have prevented 12,000 deaths in Wuhan in China. In Beijing, bike share usage increased 150%. And cities around the world closed the streets to cars, opened the space for pedestrians, cyclists. For example, Bogota is doing, they are building much more cycle lanes. They open permanently cycle lanes that they use to open only Sundays. Porto Alegre in the Brazil, they are building a lot of cycle lanes during this period. The bad, the public transport hit hard. So we are losing demand, and some surveys are saying that people are predicting they will reduce public transport use. It could be terrible for our goal to decarbonize transport. Green transport is essential for robust recovery. A green recovery could create 52 million new jobs on this after pandemic. And 20% has the potential to come from the transport sector. Green transport creates more jobs. If you invest $1 million in to build roads, you will create only 8 jobs. But if this investment is dedicated to installing charging stations, it could create between 15 and 21 jobs. If you invest this money in the EV manufacturing sector, it has the potential to create 16 or up 22 jobs. But if you expand in public transport, you have and building active transport infrastructure, you can create between 23 and 29 jobs. Here, I will describe 5 key opportunities for cities and countries. First of all, strengthen public transport. First of all, prioritize, stabilize public transport. Survival is the word. Then reimagine it through priority infrastructure, new finance, and better governance. Nigeria, for example, committed almost $200 million to compensate informal transport operators for lost revenues in 2020. They are focused to survive public transport. After that, new sources of financing for public transport. Charge for the use of individual motorized transport. I don't know, we postponed this conversation. You saw in the previous slide that the private cars ask a lot of money from the society, but we didn't. We are not asking money from the cars to use the infrastructure. You should consider to create programs to get money from the real estate valuation when the real estate valuation occurred because investments in public transport infrastructure. Double down on active transport is the best way to reduce carbon, to reduce fatalities, and to integrate, to feed public transport massive transit systems. Allocate national funds to active transport infrastructure. Cities stepped up to expand active infrastructure. Now make it permanent. As I said, examples from Bogota, Porto Alegre, In India, they are doing a lot of cycle lanes just right now. Fast track active transport and safety plans. Bogota to build 208 kilometers of new bike lanes by 2024. Mayor Claudia Lopes from Bogota wants 50% of all trips made by bike. It's an amazing number. Amsterdam has 36%. And Bogota is reaching this impressive goal, 50% of all trips made by bike. Number three, electrify transport. Accelerate the EV transition through incentives and zero emission mandates. Build public charging, it creates jobs. Decarbonize fleets, buses and commercial vehicles. It's essential to reduce emissions and at the same time to increase the level of service. E-buses have the potential to offer more quality on the service and to reduce contamination, to reduce pollution, to reduce noise. A very good example from the United States. We are working from WRI to help cities and counties to replace all e-bus fleets from diesel or gas to e-buses. Electrifying school buses can unlock 72 gigawatts of storage capacity back to the grid. Don't think only about mobility, think access and equity. Our systems, the urban mobility system, should be focused not only to move people, but to interact and to integrate people. We need to consider gender aspects. For example, in general, urban mobility planners, they are men and they are design lines without consideration of the female needs. It means we need to design public transport lines that allow people to live kids on the school, in the kindergarten, something like that. But in general, we design lines directed to the downtown, for example. And don't forget about freight. Freight is an essential component of urban mobility environment. Since United States locking down in March 2020, online home delivery sales increased 54%. By 2050, the global demand for goods will increase by 300%. Just right now, a lot of trucks, freight bicycles, they are disputing space with public transport, bicycle lanes, pedestrians, cars. So cities should consider to design a very good framework regulation to develop a sustainable freight. Think about electrification, think about road safety, and think about efficiency on freight.